I mean, people in the establishment's jaws are hanging off their faces. Nobody 6 months ago thought we'd be sitting here with Bernie Sanders on his way to the nomination. He's on his way to the nomination. Now, something could happen to stop him. Somebody might have some marbles to throw on the stairs or banana peel. They better find it.
Money.
They better find it, because this guy is off and running. And he's done something extraordinary. First of all, and I'm sure we'll hear about it from you, this is a youth quake. You got a new generation stepping up. They're not scared of any of these ideas, and they're tired of hearing Republicans call everything that we say socialist. So they've ruined the word socialist. It doesn't mean anything for the younger people. You've got the Latinos stepping up now in a major, major way behind Bernie Sanders. He's running as if he's a Latino candidate now. And these ideas are no longer as scary to a whole bunch of Democratic voters. This could be a disaster for us in the general election. It's hard to know, but this is a phenomenon. And, we got to acknowledge people underestimated Bernie Sanders every step of the way, including today.
I think that's right. I mean, 4 years ago, we saw what was possible. And again, today, we are hopefully going to see that it's actually real. It's tangible. And especially, I think, one of the biggest undiscussed stories, particularly when we're talking about Latino voters and immigrants, especially in a state like Nevada, is that his story of also having an immigrant story of his parents fleeing from persecution from Germany, and being able to really relate on a really personal level with a lot of young Latinos. And so I think that looking at these results, Latinos and people of color within the Democratic Party have waited so long for results on some of these broken promises. And you are seeing movements of young people, movements like Make the Road, who are down on the ground right now, and other Latino groups that have been doing the work for a really, really long time. And tonight is really a big moment for them. And it's emotional for them.
And you go to Sanders, I stopped by Sanders rally the other day. He's the only one on the Democratic side who can say that they have a movement.
Oh,
I mean,
absolutely.
There's no... It's not even close. I'm not talking about just numbers at rallies, but just enthusiasm and a sense of being part of something, as opposed to, oh, yeah, I'll vote for this guy on election day. It feels much more like people who are part of something.
Yeah, and there's the phrase that gets thrown around a lot in those rallies is fight for somebody else as hard as you would fight for yourself, which seems like such a bedrock of, big D Democratic principles that... I'm pleased to see that come out on the level that it has. I'm glad that that's the movement that seems to be taking storm. Especially, I mean, it makes sense when you're talking about Latino voters. Bernie Sanders prioritized them in Iowa. He prioritized Latino voters and Muslim voters in Iowa. That would not have been seen as a winning strategy until it won. And it's not because they turned out in record numbers and swamped white voters. It's because the white voters he was speaking to realized that that was an important part of their fight. It's hard to be mad about that from a progressive point of view. The one thing that I want to say about Nevada's process today, in defense, if I can, Saturday voting. If we want to make this a democratic process as much as we possibly can, let's vote on a day that most people have off.
I do want to say the problem with the Bernie movement narrative is that he's winning with like 25, 26, right. 28%. Yeah. And that includes even in a state like New Hampshire that he won cleanly with over 50% last time. And you have the other votes getting split up among four other candidates. Really, to me, the action after today is what happens among candidates 2 through 5.
Right.
Because they're going to have some very, very tough conversations. And then if the field consolidates, the question is, what percentage of the vote is Bernie getting?
Right.
I think what's important to recognize, though, is that what seems to be the case, at least looking at these numbers, is that Bernie Sanders is also doing well with moderates, too. So whereas I feel like that argument could be said for New Hampshire and Iowa, we're seeing that he is winning support across moderates, and it's less ideological and it's more about who is prioritizing the needs of the working.
This is the question, but people like winners in general. Like a lot of people looking up being like, I'm starting to warm up to this guy. Just because after you start putting up a bunch of number ones next to your name,
that's true.
You start looking better.
Everyone's a Yankees fan.